Hello everybody, my name is Stuart Jones. I'm the course leader for the MSc Music Engineering and Production course at the University of South Wales. And you're receiving this message because you've either enrolled on or expressed an interest in studying the course this year or next year, as the case may be. And this is the second video I've done. I did one earlier on in the year. I'll post a link in the comments to this message. But I thought I would provide you with an update on things as they stand now at the end of July. You would have already received a message from faculty that said we've taken the decision to delay the start of the course until January 2021, and then for the course to run from January 2021 to January 2022. You should have received that message. If not, I can forward it on to you if you'd like to read it and have it in official terms. But this is not a decision that we've reached lightly, and it's been a collective decision. There's several other courses that have delayed their start as well, and it was felt that given the situation, this was the best possible reaction, obviously to ensure your health and our health and well-being, and to ensure that teaching takes place without any without you feeling as though your learning has been in some way affected. As you can imagine, for a course like mine, we require the use of recording studios, and we have several modules that require recording studios on campus. And current government social distancing guidelines have meant that we've had to reduce the capacity, the room capacity, which makes teaching on my course quite difficult. And obviously that situation's quite fluid. It could be that the social distancing guidelines change and ease, which we hope that they will, but it was still felt that we would be in a better place in January than we are if we would have started in September. So we've decided to do that and start in January. What that means for you is that you won't become a student until January 2021. And I know this has had some implications for some of you, and I really apologize for that. Some of you that might have taken up accommodation or already be in accommodation. But it means that you won't be able to enrol on the course until January 2021. And that could affect those of you who need visas to come and study in the UK, those of you that are looking to take accommodation, or for those of you who need insurance. You can't enrol in September. I've asked and I've been told you can't enrol until the teaching starts. So I'm really, really sorry about that. I knew that there would be some fallout, so it was inevitable. But how that's going to play out. You won't be able to start until January. They won't allow you to enrol sooner. When we start in January, there'll be a semester then up until April. There'll be a second semester after Easter up until early summer, and then there'll be a third semester after that. And so we've basically just moved everything from September to January. My intention is to still do what I had already initially planned to do, which I mentioned in my last video, about having all the theory in the first semester and then all of the practical in the second semester. And as we stand at the moment, I still intend to do that. But of course, if the situation changes, it could be that we actually have some campus activity from January. So at the moment, faculty are saying that all students starting in September come in onto campus for one day a week, and everything else then is online. That doesn't really make much of a difference to the MSc, because the MSc is only 2 days per week anyway. That's all. A full-time MSc is 2 days per week. That's how it's been since it's been taught. Perhaps 2.5 days, depending on the timetable, but no more than that. So We will look then if, to see where we are in January, and if we will make a decision then. But of course, you might be thinking, well, can I then postpone? Can I start the course in January but take up accommodation in Cardiff in April? We would of course need to consider that for those of you that want to do that, who want to take up all of the modules online. You have, you know, set up at home that you can, you know, complete the courses on the modules with, but then take up accommodation for the second semester, which will start after Easter. That's entirely up to you. Please do let me know if that's what you're considering, and then I can make sure that you're catered for. But like I said, if guidelines change, it could be that we do have on-campus activity in January. And some of you might benefit from being in Cardiff anyway. Cardiff's a great city. It's a very media-rich city. There's a lot of things going on, or there was, bands, gigs. So you might feel as though, even though teaching is only one day a week, it's beneficial to you and your learning and your student experience that you're in Cardiff and you're networking and meeting people. That brings me on to the second semester then. So second semester will be theory based, so we will have all of our studio inductions. I'll be doing studio stuff in the first semester, to be quite honest. I'll be doing all of the pre-production stuff with you in the first semester, and I do already have a number of video tutorials online which have mixing desk walkthroughs, and I have a number of documents already prepared online, so we can do a lot of pre-production in the first semester. And then, of course, we would start with the hands-on practical stuff with the mixing consoles. We would have, obviously, tutorials on the consoles and Dolby Atmos suite. So there will be hands-on tutorial sessions. I've thought actually that the way to do it would be, rather than have a two hour a week type thing, is just to actually run it like a normal recording session and break you down into small groups and run week-long recording sessions. That seems to me to be the most logical way of doing it, given the situation where the faculty is trying to keep students into bubbles, so that we would learn the mixing desk through a live recording situation, where rather than it be 2 hours a week, which is the normal timetable, we just have groups of students in the studio for a week learning the equipment. That could be a way of doing it. I'll get back to you on that. But that would be my preferred method, I think, at the moment. And then obviously through the summer, you have the run of the place, because all of the undergraduate courses would have gone, they would have finished. So we would only have postgraduate students in through the summer. So there'll be you, the songwriting students and the film students, and all the other MSc and MA students working through the summer. So it's a really nice time, because you can really get in and spend time in the studios if you so wish. And then obviously working towards your final major project. So your final major project would actually start after the second semester. That's typically how it's been. But what we'll do this year is we'll better integrate final major project into semester two. So while you're working on your practical work, so you're doing recordings for the recording module, and you're working producing songwriting students on the production module, and you know, doing mixes for immersive audio and post-production, you could also if you like, wrap all this up to form your final major project. Typically that's what we've done, but this year I'm looking at better integrating semester two and semester three. So that means that if you did decide that you wanted to go back home in September 2021, which some students do, they stay for two semesters, they stay for semester one, semester two, and depending on their own personal circumstances, they might then return back home and complete their final major project remotely from home. That you would also be able to do that too from September. So if you decided that come September, you've got all the material, you've got all the recordings that you needed, and you wanted to go back home to complete your MSc, then that's absolutely fine. That's what we're looking at doing. One final thing, I won't take up too much more of your time, but one final thing, I'd be really grateful if you could give me some indication as to the equipment that you have access to at home when we do our online teaching. This has been something that's been highlighted through the past few months with us moving all our teaching online, something that we call digital poverty, where our students don't have access to equipment, or they have to borrow it, and it's had a negative effect on their learning. So typically, you know, we would expect a student to have some, you know, laptop or a desktop machine which had software on it, an audio interface, a microphone, a set of speakers, a set of headphones would be the basic sort of requirements. So, you know, you could have a PC, you could be running Cubase, Reaper, you could have some small monitors, some, you know, multimedia speakers, an audio interface, and a one microphone and set of headphones. That would be sufficient for you to take part in each of the modules. That would be the sort of entry level. Preferably, I would recommend that you have a laptop, perhaps a Mac, if it's possible, because that's what we use in music production. We use Macs, and media production, sound design, and things like that. They tend to use Macs. In the past, we've used primarily we've used Logic and Pro Tools. The reason why we use Logic is because we've been able to offer students certification, Logic certification, so they become certified users of the software. And Pro Tools as well. Pro Tools, we need to use Pro Tools for the Atmos Lab, because the Atmos Lab uses Pro Tools only. And we've also done some stuff in Reaper, which is available on a 60-day trial, but it's, I think it's 60 quid, 60 UK pounds. It's not hugely expensive, but we do some 360 stuff with Reaper because it has very flexible inputs and outputs. So that would be preferable, and obviously some decent speakers and a decent interface with a decent microphone and some headphones if you've got them. If you haven't, please do let me know, because if you want to come and start the course in January and you need that equipment, then I can spend September to December trying to do my best to source that equipment for you on a loan basis or whatever I can do. There'll be I hope there'll be systems in place for us to be able to loan equipment so that students can study from home and have the technology in their homes to enable them to complete modules. That's what I'm looking at. That would be very, very important, and I'd be very grateful if you could let me know. And of course, Wi-Fi, obviously decent Wi-Fi, so that we can Zoom call, and that you can be a part of that. So yeah, please let me know if you require any equipment. I don't think the university is suggesting we buy it, but I think they're looking into ways where they can have a loan system, a sort of a long-term loan system. I'm not too sure what's being proposed, but our technicians, our own music technicians have got equipment that would be available to you to loan on a sort of a long-term basis. So if you let me know, I can start putting things in place so that when we all start in January, we're all ready to go. We've got equipment, we've got speakers, we've got microphones, we've got basic interfaces, and we can all take part and feel as though we're a part of the course. So that would be great. And also, I've got some projects set up that you can do at home. So I'm very interested in sort of sound anthropology and acoustic ecology and project studio sort of design and those sort of things, you know, which you can be done at home and really improve your skills as a music producer, engineer, or sound sort of engineer producer. So that's what I'm thinking. And if you've got some basic equipment at home, then you can really take part in these exercises that I've planned for you. All right, I'm going to leave it there. Thank you very much. And let me know if you have any questions. Bye-bye.